66. Plane of Bliss, Anandaloka. Consciousness is truth, being, and bliss, Satchitananda. Ananda is the highest truth, the essence of being. In the process of manifestation, the self is slowly covered by five sheaths. The first and most subtle sheath is Anamayikosh, the sheath of pure being, pure feelings of pure consciousness. This is the sheath of bliss, Ananda. At the center is cosmic consciousness. During the period of manifestation, this acts as the individual consciousness. The second is the level of ego and intellect. This sheath is called Vijnanmayikosh. Vijnan is a combination of Vi and Jen. Vi means beyond, Gyana knowledge, Maya engrossed, and Kosh sheath. This sheath, which deals with the knowledge of the beyond, is ego, which perceives itself as a separate reality, and the intellect, the evaluator. The third is the sheath of the mind, the Manamayikosh, Manas equals mind. Mind works with the help of five sensory organs, the ear, the skin, the eye, the tongue, and the nose. From here comes all perception of the phenomenal world, the world of desires. The fourth is Pranamayikosh, the sheath of prana, the vital life force, the energy that operates through the five work organs and systems inside the body, including the blood vascular system, the respiratory system, and the nervous system, through which karmas are performed. The fifth and most gross sheath is the Anamayikosha. Ana means the grain or food from which muscles, skin, teeth, blood cells, and semen are composed, the phenomenal person. In the evolution of the inner self, this process is reversed. The player goes through the Anamayikosha to the Pranamayi, and crossing the four sheaths establishes himself finally in the sheath of bliss, the Anamayikosha. Ananda is the chief characteristic of consciousness. It differs from pleasure, happiness, joy, and delight. These others can be explained, observed, and evaluated. They are relative states, which intellect can evaluate and categorize. Buddhi leads to jnana, the arrow that leads to the plane of bliss. Ananda is the primordial feeling of which all others are but manifestations. It underlies feeling and always exists at the heart of the player's being. But Ananda can only be experienced directly, not observed in others. A deaf mute cannot communicate the taste of a piece of candy in words. Only movements, gestures, and expressions can be employed. Ananda cannot be described or expressed, it can only be experienced. In Arantaloka, the feeling self ended. All feelings became one when the world of sense objects became one, since feelings are based on sensory perceptions. And Prakritiloka gave the player the knowledge that all sense objects are but expressions of the one phenomenon. Here but one feeling remains, the feeling of bliss. The experience of bliss is difficult until one achieves wisdom and becomes realized. The only alternative is devoting full attention to Dharma while making the gradual journey up through the plains, avoiding all the snakes.